Hi, this is Jason from PreVeteran. Welcome back to our PreVeteran YouTube channel. Today, we're going to ask you a very simple question. What is your military transition model that is going to get you from where you are now to getting you into the industry, company, and role that you want to do post-military? Before we get started, please subscribe to our PreVeteran YouTube channel by clicking on the little red button below the video here and follow us on our LinkedIn company page, which is in the comments below. Let's get started. To kick things off, let's talk about some percentages. First percent, 100%. Those of you listening that are in uniform right now are going to get out of the military at some point. 90%. 90% plus of you are going to become employees once you leave the military. 70%, which is 70% of those 90% that are going into employment, are going to be employees in the private sector. Listening to percentages like that, you can see that if you're wearing a uniform and you're listening to this video, the vast majority of you are going to become private sector employees. The next question is, knowing that you're going to become a private sector employee, what are you doing right now? In other words, what is your military transition model that is going to get you from where you are right now, wearing a uniform, to going into the industry, company, and role that you desire once you leave the military? Now, if I were to ask you, hey, what's your transition model? What is your brain telling you right now? And if it's kind of met with confusion and silence, don't feel bad. If somebody would have asked me 8 years ago when I was getting ready for transition, hey, what's your model? I probably wouldn't have said anything either. Instead, for TAP for the last 3 years, we've talked about a very large monolithic program that gets everybody that's in the military out of the military. And it should be no surprise the logical result of a big monolithic program is it lacks individual specificity. So it should be no surprise with a big monolithic program that we've gotten a pretty poor outcome, particularly in employment when we're talking about outcomes from the existing transition assistance program. We wrote about this frequently in our first article, The Elephant in the Room, but we talk about rampant unemployment rates and then people who do actually get jobs don't retain there well. 50% leave within 1 year, 65% leave within 2 years, which means as a collective populace within the first 2 years of transition, we leave that job 4 times faster than our general public counterparts. And since that big monolithic program has led to less than optimal results when we talk about employment, guess what you've done? You guys are all smart and educated people. You've tried to create your own transition model, if you will, by putting it a bunch of different pieces of the puzzle together yourself. Let me give you a few examples. First is that led by the guise of big tech's promise of interconnectedness, you've likely gone to social media, whether it be LinkedIn or Facebook, to go look for influencers out there to see what they were doing. You've also gone and done some networking with people who are more knowledgeable individuals than yourselves. You've probably also gone for mentorship from others who have done it before you. You've got checklists and resources, and you've likely listened to podcasts as well, listening to others' experiences they've gone through transition and try to glean some information from them. So the real question is, you putting this together yourself, will this work? This trying to put together an individual approach based on all these different things that you're trying to facet together yourself. If I was to be honest with myself, I'd say maybe, but are you comfortable with maybe, might work? Remember, you're likely the breadwinner or co-breadwinner in your home. Is maybe good enough for you, or do you want to do something different? And to get a little insight into that, why it might not work and why it is a maybe, let's think about it for a minute. First, if you're talking about social media, LinkedIn, Facebook, and going to the influencers that are out there, plus networking and mentoring, right? You're talking to other people about their experience, which of course, if you take a step back and think about it, of course that's valuable information. But it misses the biggest point. What do you want to do? What do you want to do? Have you gone through the work to figure out what you want to do first, or are you just trying to get ideas listening to others? Which of course is fine, but ultimately you're going to have to figure out what you want to do, and then after that, looking for social media influencers, networking, and mentoring will become very informative once you've decided what you want to do. The other downside and why it's a maybe also is these different approaches that are out there. You're trying to aggregate all the data yourself into a big mosaic and glean information and insights from that on what you should do for employment post-military. That's a lot to ask. You've never transitioned before, therefore you kind of lack that memory, if you will, in your head. So having never done it before, it's very hard to kind of put a model together yourself to ensure that you're going to be successful on the back end of putting the pieces of the puzzle together. So if you're sick and tired of spinning your wheels or trying to put the pieces of the puzzle together, or if you're going to the social media sites, LinkedIn, Facebook, you're at networking events, you're also talking to mentors, and you're not sure how to get started, not sure which questions to ask them, or if you feel like you're spinning your wheels talking to them and really not making any progress, we've got just the thing for you. We knew this is an existing problem and a huge gap out there, so what we did is we created our own pre-veteran military transition model we want to make you familiar with. It's a simple three-step model. Let's go through the three steps right now. So step one is through our proprietary cognitive neuroscience-based modeling. You're able to identify and then mitigate those obstacles that are in your head. And once you do that, you can go successfully into step two, where we start putting new information in your head, and then you're not fighting us as much on that information. This new information relates to the differences, significant differences, between the public and private sectors and how that boils down to specific talent that they hire in their company. And then finally, in step three, once you've done the first two steps, we have you go into a very supportive and interactive iterative environment where you go through a bunch of different exercises and various activities like that that help you create new thinking. And that new thinking helps you align to the private sector and become self-transformed, which are two pillars of the pre-veteran ecosystem. So what do you say? Do you want to be an employee and you're sick and tired of just kind of spinning your wheels and not sure what to do? We can help you. If you're one of the 90%+ who want to become employees, you could go to our website now, courses page, and sign up for our employment prep course, which leverages all the modeling I just told you about and helps you identify the industry, company, and role that meets you and your core team's requirements. If you're new to PreVeteran and want to learn more about what we're all about, we recommend you go to our website, go to the About Us, and then on the pull down, go to the News and Press. Every Tuesday or Thursday, we put new content out there that is original to PreVeteran, and if you kind of scour through there, you're going to find articles for why we're different than anyone else in the market right now. And within those articles, we have YouTube videos if you want to watch the videos instead of just reading the content. Well, that's the end of the video. We hope you like the content. We will see you next week with our new video. See you then.